far as I know right now, Sam's still with the team.
Coach, what's your approach on this season after ending the season the way you did last year?
I think the biggest thing is what I talked about in the beginning is that change is inevitable, but growth is optional. So, you know, as much as I hate to say it, and don't take it the wrong way, you guys make our job really hard as coaches by telling us how good we are, how good we should be. And these kids have a very loyal, ambitious, hungry fan base that pats them on the back every day. And I think our job is to bring the reality that there very simply could have not been a national championship game. You know, if we don't have the things happen in the second half against Oklahoma, we never get that opportunity. So they have to understand that we can improve in a lot of areas. And they have to have the almost maturity level to now deal with a different side of things where everybody's talking about what you should do this year. Well, if you don't come with the same hunger, we've learned two things. There's a 2016 season, there's a 2017 season. There wasn't a whole lot of difference in the people on the roster in those two situations, but the outcomes were completely different. Why was that? Did we have an influx of talent all of a sudden in 2017? Or did we have a different demeanor? Did we have a different attitude? Did we have a chip on our shoulder? So what's going to be your motivating factor? And I think that each team is very different. My concern for this team is not understanding that, you know, they are going to be the target for everyone they play. We're not going to sit back and let people hunt us. We're going to continue to hunt. We're an aggressive team. That's what we want to be. And we're trying to grow as a team and get better. I think they'll embrace that challenge. We've got some good leaders on this team. They just got to learn how to step up and be vocal.
When you talk about having, you know, the hunger, keeping it going with Justin right on Jake's toes, how do you think that will impact him? And what for year two for Jake Rama, how do you what areas are you looking to see improvement?
Well, I think everybody can improve. I think the fact that Justin and Jake are competing is no different than every guy on our team. You know, we got about four or five spots in the secondary that are wide open for 12 guys. So why should that be different? We got guards and centers that are all competing, tackles. So none of that ever changes. That's what this program's built on. It's built on you go out every day to perform to the best of your ability. And if I don't think or the staff doesn't think you're performing to the best of your ability, then we call you out, we call you in, and we tell you that you got to do better. And I think every kid has kind of embraced that. Through the leaders we had last year, they understood that if I don't perform, there's another guy behind me that's going to push me. And that's what we want. We want it to be that way.
Hey, Kirby, you mentioned the leadership, but is there anyone in particular that you've been impressed with over the course of the offseason that stepped up to be more of a leader but maybe wasn't in that role last season?
Well, I think the most common thing would be to say, okay, what seniors, what guys played last year? I think Lamont's done a good job. I think he's got to continue to do that. Terry has been a very quiet, lead by example, works hard every day. I mean, the guy's a hard worker and people follow him. I think offensively we've got more guys in those roles than maybe defensively. I think Ledbetter's done a good job stepping up, encouraging guys, being positive and giving positive reinforcement. DeAndre Walker's trying to take on more of that role. But I think that's really where we're at now. It's like it's time to go out on the field and actually find out when adversity hits and you have pads on, you have helmet on, and you're tired and it's not just an off-season conditioning program. How are you going to respond and how are you going to help the other guys around you? We need as much of that as we can get.
Kirby, I guess just quick status updates on Matrez and D'Angelo. And Matrez, I saw he was a student-athlete a couple weeks ago. Is he, like, going in the right direction? Things seem to be going pretty well for him.
Yeah, you know, Matrez came back to the national championship game. He was able to join us. He's done everything we've asked, and he's working hard on and off the field. Been very pleased with his ability to come back and overcome some hurdles in his life. And then D'Angelo Gibbs, he had left shoulder surgery, and we had to address an injury that was there. He's doing very well with rehab, and we anticipate a full return for him in the fall. But again, excited about both those guys.
Coach, your defensive line following up on Jonathan Ledbetter. What do you see from him in terms of strides and offseason, both his skill set and then his leadership as well?
Yeah, with skill set, I don't get to see quite as much. His work ethic I've seen grow. I think he's gotten stronger in the weight room. You know, I thought that Coach Sinclair and his staff, the weight staff we had, has done an outstanding job getting our team bigger, stronger, faster. When you look at the strength gains, which sometimes are hard to measure, and everybody can say they bench more, they squat more, they power clean more, he does a really good job of harnessing that and not putting him at risk of injury through single rep maxes. He does a really good job protecting us there, but Ledbetter's gone up in that regard. We've had some guys that we thought needed to gain some weight that did, and then we've got a lot of guys that we thought needed to lose some weight, and they've done that as well. But Ledbetter's one of those guys that really pushes the limit, and he pushes himself hard, and been pleased with where he's at.
A little bit further on Jonathan. Not so long ago, I mean, he had a tough, his life was tough. Where is his life right now compared to what it was 2 years ago?
Well, I certainly feel like he's in a good place. I mean, he's become a vocal leader on our team. He's a guy that when he speaks, people listen. They listen to people who've had hard times and fell on hard times. He can speak on an experience that not all of our players can speak on. So he's been through some really tough times, and he certainly changed the narrative on his story to this point. And I think how this season goes and how his finishing up of his Bulldog career goes will speak volumes to who he is as a person. And he can have a great impact on this team because of his leadership role and because of some of the trials and tribulations he's been through. He can speak on it and speak from experience.
Kirby, you talked about trying to kind of tamp down the expectations somewhat, or at least, you know, the hype around this team. Can also the way the season ended and coming so close, can that be a motivation? And are you using that to kind of build a fire in this team that, you know, one play away really from winning it all last year?
Yeah, I think that team is that team, and we kind of absorb that and embrace that. And to start with your first statement, I don't think that I can put down those expectations. That the expectations are what they are at University of Georgia. The expectation is to win every game you play. Why should it be any different? So we want to create that brand that we expect to go out and dominate our opponent. That's what we thrive to do. That's why we go and lift weights. That's why we go and run. We want to dominate every opponent. That's our goal, is to go out and dominate our opponent. It's not about what you guys think, what the fans think. It's not about any of that. It's about what we can do to make sure that our players are playing at the highest level every week in and week out. And that's our ultimate goal. So we're not going out there with the mantra that we were a play away, two plays away, because just as soon as you say that, we're a play away from not being there too. And the bottom line, this team is distinctly different than that team. So what will be the identity of this team is all I'm worried about. I'm worried about who's going to be the leaders, what are going to be the traits? Are we going to be better at getting turnovers? Are we going to be more explosive? How are we going to change offensively? Where are we going to evolve to? Those are things we got to see so we can find out where we're going. But we're certainly not sitting back patting ourselves on the back like a lot of our players are getting in the public.
How valuable is it to have Cade Mays here this spring to compete, I guess, at right tackle, and with left guard, who's competing at that spot?
Well, it's valuable to have every one of those guys. Don't you think it's valuable to have Justin Fields here and competing, and Devod Wilson? I mean, at a position we lost some like 10 DBs left, and they had played forever. So now we've got a guy to come in and compete. Trey Hill, I'm excited to see him compete. You know, Warren Erickson, here's a guy that's going to come in here. Kyaris Jackson. I mean, every one of those guys I'm excited to have. Zamir, can he learn and get blitz pickups? Can he grow as a player without actually practicing? So I'm super excited about every one of those. There's a competition at every single position out there. So I've not singled out a position like you guys like to do and say, well, they lost these outside backers. We're going to have this great outside backer battle. We're going to have a battle at every single position. And that's called recruiting. It's called depth. I mean, I'd love nothing more than to see Warren Erickson and Trey Hill pushing Lamont Gaffney. Y'all already given Lamont a starting job. I mean, every article I read, Lamont's, he's just going to start because he started last year. Kendall Baker, he's got his spot. So if they go out there thinking that, I would be disappointed in them. I think if you ask them, they understand that I better be one of the best five or I won't be starting.
Well, to go to another position question. At running back, obviously, Nick and Sony did so much for you guys. How excited are you to see DeAndre, Brian, and Elijah kind of get some springs, work at that spot?
Well, the great thing is we got to see two of those guys get a ton of work last year in the spring, where you guys might not have got to see them get a ton of work because you saw the two studs out there carrying it all the time. We got to see a lot of that. So we get to see DeAndre jump into that battle, that fray with those two. We get to find out a lot about who's going to be the competitor on special teams? who can replace 127 snaps somebody took on special team? Because right now, none of those three have stepped up to the plate to say, I can be as valuable a special teamer as Sony was. Nick Chubb took every single rep last spring in special teams in two different phases. Now, we didn't use him in the season because we didn't have to. But who of those three is going to say, I can lead this spot, I can contribute on special teams, I can do every pickup right, I can protect the ball right, and I can go out and affect the rest of the team by the energy and attitude I practice with? That's what I want to see. I want to see which one of them is going to go to class the most, which one's going to have the highest GPA. Because there's a great battle there, and we can certainly use all three of them, and hopefully we'll get to use Amir and James Cook as well when they're healthy and they can go.
Got time for two more questions?
Kirby, talk about wanting to still hunt even while having the target on your back. How do you use that mindset as coaches in spring practice this year versus last year when you're trying to, I guess, elevate?
Well, we were hunting last year.
Last year, we're trying to get the team to have that target on your back, I guess.
Now, I'm not ever trying to get the target on my back. I don't think that's the right approach. Now, mentality-wise, we don't go around saying, let's go get this target on our back. We're target practice. It's the same thing I told you over South Carolina. Everybody's like, why in the hell would you onside kick against South Carolina? We're doing aggressive things that we think are right. So we're doing the same thing right now that we did last year. Every coach on our staff, we did a quality control of what we did well, what we did poorly. What can we improve on? We sat in here yesterday with 130 players, and we said last year on the composite special teams rankings, we were dead last. So our goal in the spring was to move. Fall camp, move. Perform on the field, we moved. We moved to composite first, second, depending on how you look at it. So now, are we going to not talk about special teams anymore? No. We're trying to move up nationally. We're trying to move up. We're continuing to hunt because that's what we believe. When you play aggressive, you watch all those basketball tournaments. I watch all these basketball tournaments over and over and over. The more aggressive team wins. The team is playing aggressive. I'm not going out here not to lose. I'm going out there to play aggressive. So we'll continue to do that by how we practice, because the offense is going to go against the defense. The left guard is going to go against the right guard. The left receiver is going to go against the right cornerback, and we're going to be aggressive. We're not going to go out there and sit back and say, what is somebody else doing? We're worried about us.
Just a real quick follow-up about Zamir. I know he's obviously got a few months to go. Do you have any indication at all at what point he may be able to get on the field in, you know, fall camp, early season?
Yeah, that's hard for me to answer because I am not a doctor. I don't know. He certainly looks good right now. He's progressing along. He's maybe ahead of where we expected him to be. But to say he's going to be there fall camp ready to go, I don't know that. I mean, you guys will get to see him out there. He'll probably be doing some individual drills. You make your own assessment, because I think that's the challenge for us, is not knowing where he's going to be, and also the health of our three current backs coming out of spring practice.
Thank you.